Can you teach a person to be a conductor?
I can, providing he's talented. You want to be taught by me, I can see.
I want to be a conductor, yes.
I can see your eyes that you would like.
I was a child prodigy conductor, and I gave it up for this field.
All right. I can teach very well a talented person. Oh, yes. Because there are things which you can learn. The basic learning is suffering, but you have to do it alone. Really. Basically, you learn by experience. But there are some technical problems which one can ask and which one can practice, which one can say.
I have been at a concert, and I'm trying to do this just in my head. And the conductor baton is always before I hear the music. So a great conductor must beat ahead of the music, not on the music. Because if you beat on the music, they play still slower.
Yes, the real conductor will beat always a little bit before, and the not conductors behind or at the same time. And that's image to distinguish a leader from a non-leader, and that you never can learn, never.
People say you are retiring from the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. Is that a word that you love to hear?
I'm very glad that you asked that. No, God or not. What I am doing after 22 years, I felt the 91 in which the orchestra will be 100 years old is a marvelous sort of moment to stop. 91, I will do in Salzburg the 200 years Magic Flute, the Jubilee Magic Flute, new production, which will be 200 years that Mozart died, and 200 years that the Magic Flute was written. Beside of that major operatic project, please do understand, I am not parting for Chicago. I want to come back every year, and I will come back, I promise them. 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 6 weeks, whatever. Whatever they want me. To conduct this orchestra, who are my children.
Now, I don't want to be Geraldo here, but I have to ask you. You had children relatively late in life.
Yes.
Are you happy it was that way, or would you rather have had your children when you were very much younger?
Look, I am very happy as it is, because they are wonderful children, and I love them more than anything in my life or everything. My family is, for me, much more important than music. But of course, probably it was a great mistake. My elder daughter was born, I was 57 years old. Probably would have been much better if I were 27. On the other hand, probably I wouldn't love them as much. Probably it wouldn't be so important as they are now to me today. So you see, there's always a compensation for everything.
If Sir George Solti had to spend the rest of his life on a desert island, and he could take with him the recorded music of any one composer, which composer would you choose?
No answer for that. I hope I never come to that desperate choice. No, it would be sad. We have such a wonderful garden of beautiful fruits. I pick only one. The last 300 years written music is a miracle of our life.